pretty stoked. I've figured out a way to recover a log for all of the votes that have ever been made, dating back to before I actually started logging those votes. So I started logging them in like May of 2016. Before that, my only way of having access to that vote history is through the chat log, which is a giant mess, right? It's like, you know, more than, I think it's 600,000 lines of chat from when I first started streaming in February of 2015. And I've like changed the format for how PeakPeak reports vote results. The fact that I can recover all of them and put them into a single log means I get to do metrics and some other cool trend reporting on vote history once I have everything pulled out and recovered. So details on that will come out with the February Patreon report. Let's see. Hey, Time Dragon. Alright, that's frustrating that Chat Relay is still doing that from YouTube. I talked back and forth with Restream Chat this morning, and they said that they had fixed it, and there's even a patch out that says that the YouTube doubling is resolved. I will go ahead and disconnect YouTube for now. Beam should continue to work without problems, so. Let's do. I guess we went ahead and just took the AoE attack, right? Right, don't want to use fire against Horus. Roger. Unless if it's just that he opened with magic repel. That's more likely what happened there. Not quite. No Trico. I keep casting Gate of Hell in the hope that it petrifies, and then it's just GG, right? Quite nice. I really hate this enemy. Don't miss. You can't miss. You can't even cast it. Yeah, he's over power charge then. And that we already beat it, right? Really like to get my hands on Medea Rahan, but I don't think that's gonna happen. I do have Dia Rahan, we'll see. At least she can res. I'm gonna do a mind charge. I'll have her res heat, and I'll see if I can do a full heal after that, maybe. Although, given that the enemy keeps like AoE casting at us, I don't know if a res is gonna cut it here. See what he does this turn. Hey, that was actually the best possible thing he could have done there. Cool. Okay. Right on. Power charge and then diorama. How'd everybody's weekend go? Still pretty far from being able to do enough damage here. Don't miss. Okay. I should just pass and kill it, right? Heal outside of battle. When I used to work at Airnet, me and all the other employees went in on buying a bag of Starbursts and then switching out, like, So, I traded away all of my pink, red, and orange Starbursts for everyone else's yellow Starbursts and so on. It was a good day. Let's see, what's everybody looking at now? They already have Medea Rahan, and I just never equipped it. That's possible. If not, I should, like, learn it right away. No, just Dia Rahan. About you guys. Yeah, what the heck? Why didn't I do that? Okay, let me switch what they're learning currently. She shouldn't be learning death magic and she should be getting a full party heal. This guy was strong against everything. If we wanted to use void death against him too, I don't know if it's gonna matter too much. Yeah, I remember going for debilitate, but I think it's more important for her to have a full heal before she gets that. Do they sell Pre-Sword and Starburst? Don't miss this time, Heat. Okay. Oh, that's awesome, Boulder's Heat. I wonder what the markup is. There's Chirp. Get Mantra. I think this Dark Spirit thing he's working on, not terribly important. It's like down this path, isn't it? And it wasn't too nasty to learn. It wasn't great either, but it could be worse. And we wanted to get her the second level revive too. I guess we have the revival orb. I totally forgot about that, didn't I? And that's why I stopped. Okay, because I was like, I just have the revival orb. I have no reason to go down this tree. Well, I still want to go down that tree if I want to be able to do a full party heal. I guess I could swap them in to do it if necessary. Okay, that's tomorrow, Sornus. How you doing? Bear with me, I've got another cough again. I think it's the dry winter weather suspended itself for a couple weeks here in Los Alamos and then came back. So I might have to hit mute and cough a whole bunch right now then. I'm not actually sure how close we are to the end of this game, but it definitely feels like this is the final dungeon. It's possible we'll beat it and be able to switch to Tactics Ogre before the end. Yeah, sorry. They're probably immune to it, right? Real quick, just in case there's something important there. You kitties, you're so furry. Aww. I keep catching Cat Cam right as they're like stretching and getting comfortable, and just become like a static image. Ben, Marty. They don't even care. So sorry. Sure, Specky. Okay. This is a cool looking enemy. I don't know if I want to fight it though. Don't think it's worth the. Oh, goddammit. It's very dangerous to fight. You can do that, among other things. I don't think it gives that much more Atma and XP than the other enemies. Alright, so there's two staircases there. This guy even is questionable whether it's worth fighting. Maybe if one of them drops noises or something, I could see the merit. Speaking of which, let's see if I have any noises I can use here. Nope, just cells. Hey, Serp, what's green? That's why there's a dead end below me. Okay. They do respond to their names. Marty will come running. In the evening, if we don't see him. Does it every night. Not when he's sleeping, back. This is not that bad. I think he's buff enough to one-shot them without heat having to use Gate of Hell. And so he begins firing. Yeah, okay. So that's a good group. Makes sense, right? Okay, that makes sense. This guy should be able to take out. Might take two turns, but I don't remember him being super dangerous. Okay, I need to do two rounds. Good. Really crossing my fingers and hoping everything goes well with the Switch delivery this Friday. Hearing some Amazon horror stories lately. Never had a problem, but I've also never pre-ordered anything game-related from them. Almost always do digital pre-orders, you know. You can't really do that with hardware. How did Surf get full MP? I haven't gotten to a place that covers it. I haven't used any items on him. He was like almost out too. I don't think he got a level up that restored it. Not worth it. really cool looking enemy. Oh yeah, Shacklerwalk, I forgot about that. I'll have to unequip that for the boss fight, so I can do me a lot of good. Man, it's really crazy how much MP that gives you if you have 99 magic. So these guys are weak against wind, I think. The ones on the outside, anyway. I'm not sure about Ganesh. They may have been immune to physical. Don't think Ganesh is immune to physical, though. Ganesh absorbs wind. Probably shouldn't fight this guy with these guys because of that. Try running away here. Yeah, unless if I can kill them in a single turn, which I can't, I don't think it's worth it. I feel like a lot of the enemies in this dungeon are set up to punish you for trying to use a single elemental AoE. So we don't want to go up the first staircase this time. Like the universe they're setting up to propagate on? Hey Serp, you're just now checking up on Discord. You're talking about Hollow Knight? I think we hosted someone who was playing that. It's like a Metroidvania with Dark Souls sensibilities. Sounds like a pretty cool cell. How long is it, do you know? There we go. Sounds great. Come on, your ass is mine. Tech level, right on. Is it like a custom setting that your GM came up with, or it's your player, right? But how does that work? How are they? Are you, like, taking their suggestion on crafting a setting, or how is your player coming up with that? That's cool. Cool beans. What else you can... The trick is, be a Patreon subscriber and keep putting on games shorter than 10 hours that everybody wants to see. Fire damage was okay, I think. As long as it doesn't use magic repel. I can kill Horus really fast if Petrify lands on Gate of Hell. I don't really know what the percent chance is. Oh, okay, prompt. That makes more sense. I understand. I think that Horus had a noise that he dropped occasionally. I don't know if I've seen it drop yet, but... Lana's on the voting spreadsheet. Saving up helps too. I mean, your personal votes for Monkey Island 2 and 3 was like what? About 12,000 SP? Is that right? 700 plus 500? Or 7,000 plus 5,000, I should say. Math out how long that takes. So that's like... Yeah. 10,000 hours watched without the sub bonuses. It's gone up and down a bit over time. I have a feeling I'm gonna hate this area. Oh, please don't put us all to sleep. Oh god. This is the party that, if it ambushes us, could just end the game. If they luck out enough with hits here. That's awesome, Grubhaven. Yeah, I think you're gonna beat it today, DPs. I only did a couple optional bosses. I like that killing the optional bosses carries over stuff into the second game, though. That's neat. Oh, shit. I should be able to use a revival orb. Can't forget that I have that. Watch it actually be one of those first two, right? Yeah, it's a super cool game. It makes me a lot more excited to check out the main SMT series, little DPs. I feel like the timing's worked out that I've been introduced to this series in a good order, you know? So I think I liked Persona the least, this game like an order of magnitude more than Persona, and then from what people have been telling me about the differences between Digital Devil Saga and the main Persona series, that once we get to like SMT3 or one of those games, that I'll really be hyped for it. This game has been great though. It's very mechanics focused, which I wasn't expecting coming into it. You know, you'll often go for long stretches in just a single dungeon. Because like the first few hours of the game were really story heavy, and they kind of moved on from that. Is Digital Devil Saga 2 any good? I know that Spikey had started it. It sounds like they didn't actually change too much from this game, which is a bit of a bummer. Okay, so now Gale has Madeira. Yeah, that'll be fun to do in a tabletop setting, propagating. Totally agree. That's too bad. Like, they have a cool setting here. There's a lot of, like, quality of life improvements they could have made into the sequel. It's really neat that they have so many things that carry over, too. I think that I mentioned this earlier, but having the super bosses in the first game give you a reward in the second game is the best possible solution I've ever heard for super boss rewards. Like, it's such a pain in the ass to beat Emerald Weapon and Ruby Weapon and get some item that would have been really great if you had had it when fighting Emerald Weapon and Ruby Weapon, you know? I wonder if they originally meant for this game to be longer or something. I'm splitting it into two titles. Shit, I should have used an attack there. kill him next turn. And try doing Zondyne, maybe. You know, if he's strong against wind. He's not. It should be fine. Yeah, Koopa. Seems pretty painful. I want to do SL1 for Dark Souls 3 next, after the DLC comes out. And then Bloodborne. I'm probably not going to bother with... I'm going to do this one. I'm not going to bother with Demon's Souls or Dark Souls 2. That doesn't seem terribly fun. How long did Fume Knight take you, Goomba? Yeah, I think that's... That was going to be my question. I would consider doing a Dark Souls 2 SL, however many soul levels I need to get my adaptability to a reasonable point playthrough. Like, don't put points into any other stats, just spend them on the dodge roll tax stat. That's frustrating. I don't actually need to use heat here. Since this is a cheaper, I'm gonna have to like leave the battle and then heal him whenever I do Zondyne. I'm with you, DPs. Yeah, I'm down to check out more of the series. There's definitely cool stuff here. There's some things that are frustrating, but you could say the same thing about, like, Dragon Quest, right? Yeah. Dodgy. Womp womp. Yeah, it sounds pretty rough. Nice, lucky petrify. Seems like a series that really likes spin-offs, huh? It's just an Atlas thing. Like, not in your main playthrough? Dude, Goomba, all I can advise... When I streamed it, I just spent a couple hours off-stream killing all the goddamn reindeer. It's way too frustrating. There's a couple summon signs there for like NPCs you can summon to help you kill the reindeer, and I totally advise that you do that. I think this guy takes fire damage, maybe. So we'll find out. Yeah, it's... Those three, like, hey, let's make a really, really brutal, salty run back. Bosses in Dark Souls 2 are pretty bad, although that one's by far the worst. Oh, Brewski, when you when you play Dark Souls 2, you're not going to say poor reindeer. This is unparalleled frustration. It's pretty bad. I think what the developers were getting at is they were expecting you to summon help to help you get through the area and fight the boss, but if you're trying to, like, do that solo, oh, it's the worst. Oh my god, it's... The mosquitoes are nothing. They're really not a big deal. Yeah. He's gonna fuck you up. All of the other reindeer are also gonna fuck you up. Yeah, it's bad news bears. Vagrant Story. That's one of the Japanese games that starts with V that I always confuse. So that's not... Is that the one in Ivalice, or is that Valkyrie Profile? Vagrant Story is the one in Ivalice, okay. So it's like an action RPG. What's Valkyrie Profile then? No, it's like Parasite Eve, that's cool. So you need to beat Parasite Eve someday. Oh, clever. I've only ever played it for like an hour. On Subblock, and then I think I rented it once and didn't get very far into it when I was a kid. Yeah, check out my Valkyrie profile. Ambush. Is the version of Vagrant Story you're playing on PSP, D-Piece, is that a remake? Like a remaster or something? Or is it just a port? I didn't know it was on PSP. I don't like this group. Ah, gotcha. Very good. Yes, kitties, you're very furry. And so sleepy. Looking forward to another save point here. I'm worried. There's always a chance I'll get into that group of enemies that can cast sleep on you and then insta-kill you. Wasting all this Atma, because I'm assuming that there's going to be a save point like right around the corner. Oy vey. Seems more likely to lead somewhere productive. I guess not, disregard. Is the save point hidden in one of the walls around here? I don't know. Like, literally hidden in the wall, or it's one of these blue things I have to stand on that takes me to a room with a save point? I see. Cool. Let's see if I can find it. Good looking out. Sure. I just like to switch out my mantras, that's all. Mind charge rocks. Okay. May have been in like the previous room. Sure, I certainly didn't check all of them, so it's possible. Really? Nope. Not great. Oh boy, oh boy. I think I can technically petrify this guy. Don't think it's worth trying, though. I feel like those guys aren't really... Do they still have... Yeah, they still have the Manawak on. Maybe it's back there somewhere. This might actually be where we want to go. There's like an elevator down there I don't need to be taking. Oh no, I can't actually draw through there. Okay, that's fine. The way the map isn't terribly clear in here. Now to try to remember how the hell I got over to that side in the first place, right? This might be right. Don't think we want to mess with that door at all. This looks correct. Yeah, I think this is right. Hey, these guys. I hope you will. You say Dacunda removes the effects of debilitate, is that correct? See if I have something like that. Cancel Kaja. I don't think I have Cancel Kunda. I might have stuff to buff the party. Three undo spells at once. Okay. I don't think this does enough damage to matter. So I kind of have to just pass her turn, which is unfortunately a bit of a waste. Bummer. Let's see how many of them run now. Nope, it's not happening. Now how come I only had two turns that time? That's weird. Oh well. I did kill them once. It was pretty cool when it happened. Yeah, that was some wonk right there. Oh, right. I forgot about that. Steel piece. I thought that still... For some reason, it didn't occur to me that that applied when I was using the handgun. Hey, I can swap mantras. Trying to get Medea Rahan for the final boss, but if we can't, we can always swap in the other two characters. Over Argilla. He's still learning when he's currently on. Yeah, no, that's okay. Don't need the ultimate heal magic. Don't really need anything else for Gale, I don't think. I guess I could look at Seraphim if I can find it here. Yeah, right. I wish it were easy to hit them. Maybe their debuff is what makes you so... makes your accuracy suck so bad. Excuse me. It kind of has a long hallway feel to it. Wait, what does it say? Overwhelming presence can be felt from the other side of the door. Sounds pretty final. Really high elevation too. I'm just gonna run to the restroom, so I'll play the long hallway song. Be right back.
You know what that is? It's the long hallway. You know it's at the end, right? It's the boss. You ready? Let's go beat it.
Finally, it's the long hallway at the end of game. It's a trope, not a cliche. Judgment Day, the boss is right this way. Can't let him slip away. Come and join me in the long hallway. Hallway, hallway. It's the long hallway. Hallway, hallway. The long hallway.
That's a pretty cool trope.
Sorry for the audio void. Got pressing that button cut out the game music. Let's do it. Replaying the Cyber Shaman's recorded message. Sorry everyone, I remember everything now. I want you all to stay here. Please don't come any closer. Okay, so this probably actually isn't the final boss. My answer is no. It'd be a little bit more fanfare for that, right? Try to figure out what elements I can damage it with, though. Okay, fire seems to work. How about physical? Physical's also fine. What about wind? Wind is not okay. Roger. Holy shit, look how many turns this thing has. You need to like force it to miss occasionally to make this viable. Maybe snap into your rest. The effect on Surf right now is panic, is that correct? One turn for each of its heads. Wow, that's crazy. Didn't you say that Orochi's in this game too, is a Hydra that has like 8 turns? Yeah, I will take a chance here. I'm gonna raise evasion or something, make him miss turns. Yep, just keep focusing down the one person, it's great. Yeah, for sure, Deep Peace, which I think Heat has access to. Oh yeah, yeah, keep attacking Heat. Do that over and over, please. Oh my god, Heat, you have high counter. That's supposed to be like an 85% chance. Wow. You suck, Heat. You got hit 7 times and countered twice. Some people's double-headed cannibal demons, man. Disappointed. I should swap out Rakarm for her. I'm never going to use it because I have a Revival Aura that does the same thing. Could maybe swap that out for the Diarrhahan, or for just Diarrhahan. Ew. A strong 15% chance. There's one. Two. RNGesus is trying to make up for sucking. 2 out of 3. Still not good, but I'll take it. A better heal ultimately. By that logic, though, shouldn't Heat get to go twice? He has 2 heads. There you go. Good job. Proud of you. Great moves. Keep it up. Oh, wow, that was unusually high amount of atma for a boss. I feel like they traditionally don't give a ton. Hey, there's another save point right there. What a treat. So let's dump Rakarm for Diarrhahan. Did I not get that yet? No shit. Huh, well, I'll give her something else that's at least kind of useful. I guess Tarakaja for now. What the hell is she working on? I could have sworn I learned this like forever ago. Guess it would be highlighted a different color if it was already learned, huh? Yeah, I should be working on that instead of this one. It's too bad. This one's almost done. Might as well finish off. Although it might not matter. Hmm. ban me back with Marty already, buddy? Catch up to you no matter what. Hey, it's a point of no return. Alright, well, I'll go make a backup save file in case I want to fight the optional bosses off stream. For the save file transfer. Assuming that's easy enough to do. Definitely won't do the super boss, but the regular optional bosses I can probably take. Alright, let me think really quick about what abilities I want everyone to have before I walk through the door. Oh yeah? So, like, if you say no and leave, it triggers a bunch of other optional bosses? That's interesting. Don't need Chakra Walk anymore. I guess I could take another element. I don't have Mabufu Dine, but I could take, like, Mabufu La. Or just regular Bufu Dine. See if there's anything else I'd want to take instead. Magic Repel? Eh, it's probably a bad idea. Drain, maybe, but not Repel. Death Resist? Maybe. I should probably have... Do I need to worry about Void Death during the final boss fight? Or whatever's past that door, I should say. I'll maybe leave Argilla with it just in case. I don't need Quick Escape anymore. Maybe give him Medea-Rama. He's not great with it, but it's better than nothing. Oh, I never learned it from him. Okay, well, that makes that easy. Physical Drain, maybe? Don't need Void Death. Okay, thank you. If you give him Ice, what does that require that I dump? I also want to take here. Do the magic attack up. That's generally a good idea, I think. Hopefully the boss doesn't, like, ignore physical or something. Right? And I switched, to last word, right? Okay. Cool. Bufu should be fine, I think. Yes, yes. Oh my god. There we go. Let's do it! Whoa. Does the door actually tell me I can't go back? It does. Or it doesn't let you interact with it at all. Interesting. This is the long hallway. tactics ogre. That's why we changed the voting deadline system to have a game to switch to. It should be listed on the schedule.
Angel! I know you're here!
Douchebag God. I said, y'all need to go eat people. That's interesting. What's that all about?
Thanks to them, the shell has finally cracked open. You caused me quite a bit of trouble.
So they both have black hair, which is significant. Only Sarah has black hair.
Will you leave the junkyard alone?
I do not like wasting time. Do you really think I'd agree to that? Knowing what I plan to do through you?
No! I can't do such horrible things!
Who's this dude?
Impressive, but you are the only remaining cyber shaman. It took 5 years to perfect the virus, but you can already use it with ease. However... I do not like wasting time. This wasn't easy to find. You care that much? Since you show no signs,
so it's like her persona.
I'll make this simple for you.
It's not the same as us. We actually turn into demons, literally. Sarah stands for Seraphita. She's the human character. She's like not a robot like everybody else. She's the one that landed at the beginning of the game and started this whole nonsense about us all eating each other. I don't know who the long-haired chick is, though. She was previously the computer we were talking to, or controlling the computer we were talking to, Angel.
These are clouds?
I guess she's also a user from the real world to continue using reboot terminology, because that's the best I can understand about this universe so far. Yeah, no kidding, Yukipo. It's actually what happens in reboot.
This don't look good.
I knew Sarah was controlling the thing, but that's different from us, right? Because she like has a thing she can summon that protects her. Unless if we're also her summons? That would be cool, right? If like she's a Shin Megami Tensei protagonist, and instead of playing as a protagonist with a bunch of Pokemon that she summons, we play as the Pokemon themselves. Someone as powerful as Sarah is probably the answer. When we're issuing commands in combat, we're actually Sarah doing that the whole time. In a couple different directions they could take it. Yes, Heat. I can tell.
Stop! I'll do anything you say! Please!
It's a long spiral staircase.
Don't delete them! Sarah!
Is that Angel?
Thank you for coming.
Seraphita, she is kind of like an angel name too, right?
This matter no longer concerns you. So why don't you be good little children and leave?
We've had enough of your damn orders! We are taking Sarah to Nirvana. So get your snobby bitch ass out of the way!
Oh, heat.
Stay back!
That's why she was able to sing earlier to clear some of our status effects, like hunger. I think she's the Pokemon master.
That we could say goodbye.
Yeah, some people snobby bitch asses.
Don't. You can't.
You know, the evil chick is of like the same ilk as Sarah. So they both have black hair.
Please stop. I beg you.
This is like that Butterfree episode of Pokemon.
You are beautiful. To survive, you devour others. A demon epitomizes karma in its simplest form. That should not be wasted. But your hopes and beliefs are utterly worthless. We shall see the maturation of the seed I have sown in you!
Bring it on!
So she has a traditional summon, or form change. That's interesting. Interesting. Okay. Right on. I'm on board. Start buffing the party. Assume that she's able to remove our buffs and debuffs, so. Yeah, like that. At least that used up her turn. Well, that's pretty good. Also pretty good. Okay, she must have a ton of forms like the final Persona 3 boss, right? Is last word the highest possible amount of single target almighty damage, or is there another step above that? Yes, yes. Onmyo. Should the name Onmyo or Harihara inform me anything about the story? I don't recognize either of those. Optional boss gives you a stronger almighty spell. Interesting. Omnio is exorcist. Interesting. Ow. That didn't feel good. That was pretty sweet. We must be triggering a form change whenever we see red health in this one. I wonder if the extra damage dealt is being wasted or it's carrying over into her next form. Oh boy. I don't have any way to remove hunger anymore, though, do I? Okay, Sarah still shows up. But I think she can only help one of us per round. So Surf is just screwed this turn. He doesn't do anything really irritating this one, though. Executioner is the strongest target, single target physical. Okay, good to know. Might as well try to just do both of these. Vaikunta? Ow. Oh, that can petrify. Okay, so I guess we do want Void Death if we die. That's okay, I can turn it on next time. I should do this stone so we don't just lose a turn. Good deeps. Shiva and Vishnu. Interesting. Let's get some misses in here. Alright, very good. I can handle one. I'm trying to do an unpower charge execution here. She was already at red health. It might make enough of a difference. We'll see. Phase change. Let's go face changes every time. Genocide. It's physical, right? Ow. She got a crit, which is a bummer. But that's not enough. It's not. Lucky me. Ends here. You shall not escape this purgatory. Instant form change. Boo. Oh, she's just alternating between two forms? Except now. Now she's doing something different, right? Right, in the final phase she petrifies all of us, right? Since we didn't decide to waste our turn with Void Death. Okay. Oh, who wants to bet each of those are... Okay. Cool elemental stones. Gotcha. Let me heal everybody. Guessing their colors and I'm concerned with you. I don't know if she actually does anything physical, but just in case. Alright, so Earth should be weak against wind, is that right? Yeah, okay, that's not too bad. This is cool. Okay, so she can resummon one. And it creates a elemental repel shield. Against the boss only, I'm guessing? Ooh, physical drain is the shit. See how many turns she had there? So let's do that again. Right. Ufu against fire. And I might be able to use the one that hits all of them after that, maybe. Let's see. Your powers combined. Assume my buffs from earlier wore off. Maybe it'll be nice to do Megidola next time too. So I think this is gonna work. So we'll see. Yeah, that's the ticket. Okay. Gotcha. I'm glad I bought Bufudine. I was like, I'd like to have an extra element just in case. I assume there's some elemental shenanigans. Electric Repel. Is that really what you're supposed to do? Like, blow up the one that's giving it a shield and then just use the Aja ability. Does she herself have any resistances? Or is it just from the orbs that give her them? Sure. Gotcha. That's cool. It's less critical for me to use physical drain with him now. Try using power charge. Extreme resistance to Almighty. Gotcha. Including the boss herself. Yeah, that makes sense. Or is it just the orbs that have the almighty resistance? No. Forgot to take off counter. That's okay. $17.45. Pretty good. Orbs and the boss. Okay, good to know. I should try to buff up our magic then. The surf can do crazy damage. Status effects were not physical. Okay, that's good. I appreciate that. Ah, now I can't use Meragi Dine. That's curse, not death, right? And it missed, hooray! Lucky me. It's not actually weak against that element, is it? She can always make an element core, and she gets to do one other thing, I guess. I don't yet know what determines what element core she creates. It's fine. So, Meragi Dine, or I could do Mind Charge. Should be able to do Executioner on her. No, it wasn't as good as I wanted it to be. Should heal. The one she creates is just randomly selected. Okay. That's right. Her adds that are alive, if I let one live, then it's kind of a waste. Because then they get to go, which is potentially bad for me. Okay. Keep that in mind. Well, they might not actually go, they just might give her extra turns. Nice crit. Okay, they do get to go separately. Good to know. Damn. He's probably best just using physical drain. He doesn't look like he actually hits that hard, even with Executioner. Let's surf hit for 1500 damage. I'll have to use some MP recovery items here soon. Yeah, right. Physical repel shield. Let's see. Okay, it's probably not worth ever using my turn to buff if you can do that pretty easily. Use his turn to give them great shot away. Using items on the final boss at last. A The sickness must be purged. Moons give me strength, etc., etc. Droid efficiency at its best. Great. She's getting pretty low on health here. Yeah, that makes sense, DP. So I'm guessing this is a great example of a boss where if you chose to fight the super bosses earlier, like, just dies instantly. Because the super boss, just any of the optional bosses, not even the super boss, the super boss, I should say. Probably way harder than she is. Although I'm curious what her next phase is going to be. No, that's the whole point, Propagable. I do use items on the final boss. I just save them until then. In case I need, 20 elixirs for the final, I'm going to use a total of one party-wide MP heal. Be all that I end up doing, I think, at this rate. Don't hit Surf. Shit. That's pretty bad. Wait, did it not? It looked like it hit Surf, but it didn't actually do anything. What's that all about? Like, he didn't dodge. Did he maybe get afflicted with the status effect and then it happened to wear off when his turn started? This is a final little boss. Right? It's possible. I still think there's got to be another phase after this one, right? I wonder if one of the cores it can summon has the ability to heal the boss. Just didn't hit him, huh? Lucky, lucky. Alright, phase three. Let's go. Don't.
No. Everything will disappear. Nothing can stop it.
Big stretch, kiddies.
The gate! Run to the gate!
Gale comprehends. Someone gonna grab Sarah on the way? Presumably. Really? What? Alright, because he's like the robot version of a real human who died at some point.
No! Surface still!
The robot bodies are based on real people.
Come on, bro! Damn it! He won't make it!
Maybe he's just not in the sequel. So much for going into the gate. That wasn't that big of a deal. Thanks, Steve Bloom. Friendship is magic. Maybe there isn't another boss. Wow, that boss was a lot easier than the final boss of Persona 3. Which is good. I think Persona 3 might be the most offensively designed final boss I've ever encountered in a video game. In the way it can very easily waste up to an hour of your time without interaction on the player's part. This is an easier SMT game, it's good to know. I like the idea of the final boss in that game having, like, you know, 14 forms or however many it was, but... Hey! They're just gonna end there and they're not gonna tell us what's going on with the whole reboot robot people thing. Boo! I kind of like that they leave that open to interpretation. It's, I wonder if it remains as open to interpretation in the second game, and the second game totally clarifies all that. It's pretty cool, though. I like showing, you know, the, showing Gale looking like a scientist in the real world. Maybe there'll be, like, an after-the-credits cutscene where Samuel L. Jackson shows up to invite Surf to join the Avengers. The speedrun of this game is twice as hard. How long is the speedrun, Onyx Snow? I did like this game, yeah. This game was much, much better to me than Persona. I think it knew what it was and doubled down on what it was, which was, you know, a really cool dungeon crawler with a deep battle system, a lot of interactions. Like, each individual encounter with a different set of enemies is almost a puzzle you have to solve, because you want to try to kill the enemy before they get to go. I had some complaints, like the mantra system was frustrating to have to go to a save point to swap them. It kind of like rooted me to a save point where I wouldn't, or I leashed me to a save point is a better word. I wouldn't stray too far for them because I always had to go back and replace my mantra. That's like a kind of an easy thing to fix. It's like the not being able to pick your fusion skills in Persona 3 problem, right? So that's not that big of a deal. The rate at which you get ambushed and preemptively attacked is really bad in this game. I would have toned that way down. Or change it so that ambush always means that you start in human form and the enemies don't get to go first. Because it didn't actually happen to us, but there is a significant chance that we could have been ambushed had the enemy cast an instant death spell and just be dead after, you know, 40 minutes of exploring without a save point. 6 to 7 hours, that's pretty fast. I do like narrative uncertainty. So the game did a good job there. Honestly, if this were just a movie and the movie played out like this, just the story events that happened, and then ended with that cliffhanger, it's the kind of thing that would infuriate a lot of people, but I'm a big fan of that. Like, when it's open to interpretation, everybody can hop on the forums and hop on Reddit and try to figure out what it all meant. As long as they're... You gotta be careful because there's a couple people, like the Wachowski siblings, will make content that's obtuse and, like, it's... They'll make scenes and do things that doesn't actually have a meaning, like the directors and the writers don't really have something in mind, they just put something in there that's weird on purpose to get people to theorize about it, but there isn't actually a real answer, and I get the sense from Digital Devil Saga that there really is a real answer. They're just not telling you what it is in this game. They're letting you try to figure it out. Yeah, ambush and instant death is a problem in the whole series. See, yeah, it's frustrating because the whole starting in human form thing is, for Digital Devil Saga in particular, is such a novel solution to ambushing. It's like, yeah, if you, you know, want to fight this battle at full strength, you still have to spend an entire turn transforming back into demon form. But then at least you have the opportunity, if you're much stronger than the enemies who ambush you, you can pick retreat while you're still in human form. It's a more interesting choice when you are forced into human form at the start. Yeah, I totally agree, Chaos Factor. 100%. Persona 3 was double the length of this game for no reason. Like, there wasn't a lot of value in that extra 35 hours. Because, like, it was definitely a way too little butter over too much bread situation. And I think this was just the right ratio of both of them. Yeah, it's a really good game, DPs. Big dig. I'm glad we played it after Persona 3, too. Because if I had played this first and then went to Persona 3, I'd have been like, what the fuck is this? They know how to do this right. Why aren't they doing this right? I can hear that, Yukipo. I think the issue with Persona 3 is just the way the social link system works, right? The reason that game is 70 hours long in a main story playthrough, not even a completionist playthrough, is you have to play through every single day. You know, you can't just be like, eh, I'll let 3 weeks pass automatically and just jump to the next event. I don't think I've played a game quite like that where the completionist playthrough isn't that much different from the main story playthrough. Yeah, I've liked what I've seen of Persona 4 so far. It's improved in a lot of ways. Yeah, I suppose that's true. I mean, it's comparably long, right? It's the same problem. You have to do everything every single day. Yeah, you could go in probably too much of a content gulf in between the big plot events. Like, if it wasn't once a month, at every full moon, it was once every 2 weeks or something that something happened, or even once a week, I think it would work a lot better. And Nick Fury's gonna show up. Whoa, what's this all about? Where are we at? Interesting. She was jacked into this machine, possibly. That's pretty cool. This reminds me of the Kingdom Hearts 100% ending. It looks like a totally different setting overall. Maybe they're not digital anymore. Maybe they're real world, real people now. There's a 300 plus hour speedrun. 100% speedrun. Are you ready for the real world? I guess it really was. Okay, it was a reboot type story. We were in a computer. How do we go about being robots in the real world? I wonder. Well, that's a cool way to do New Game Plus. So you restart the game at level 1, but all of your mantras stay unlocked. I'm down with that. Get the analog devil socket. Right. So this save file that I'm creating is what will transfer over to DDS2, I guess. If I don't go and beat the optional bosses off stream. Rock and roll. We'll be back in a few minutes with Tactics Ogre. Let us cling together for the PSP, since we beat Digital Devil Saga early. I'll be back soon. Thanks. Hey everybody, we're back. Give me one sec to get set up here with Tactics Ogre.